I'm George Ratio, senior economist with Realtor.com. This week confirmed that the economy and real estate markets are moving toward a more balanced state. Orders for durable goods like cars, appliances, and airplanes rebounded in May, a sign that US manufacturers continue expanding even as labor and supply shortages remain a drag. This week's jobless claims declined with more Americans finding employment. In some industries, employers are offering higher starting wages and sign-on bonuses to attract workers, a positive sign for the economy. Real estate markets are also showing signs of normalization, with the heated intensity of the last 6 months beginning to moderate. Sales of new homes slipped again in May as home builders passed along sharply higher construction costs to buyers who are facing record high prices. Realtor.com data showed that buyers want larger homes with garages, home offices, and updated kitchens in quiet neighborhoods. While this buyer profile is an ideal match for the newly built suburban and exurban homes, real estate markets struggle with a gap between what buyers want, what they can afford, and what's available. Underscoring the affordability challenge, with prices almost 24% higher than a year ago, and the number of homes for sale still hovering near historic lows, sales of existing homes declined in May for the fourth consecutive month. Adding to affordability pressures, the 30-year mortgage rate rose above 3% as investors remain concerned about inflation. Without additional supply, favorable financing is not enough to overcome record high prices. Mortgage applications increased this week, boosted by homeowners looking to lock in low rates before they rise in the second half of the year. This week's Realtor.com data point to an inflection in real estate activity, suggesting we may be past the peak of this overheated housing market. Last week marked the first time in about 4 months that the decline in time on market moderated. Additionally, sellers continue to list more homes for sale. The net effect is a welcome slowdown in listing price growth. This week, we also released our newest data on Gen Z, the youngest demographic cohort. The generation is just starting on its adult life journey with over a third still in college. The big takeaways, 72% of Gen Z wants to own a home in the future and 45% expect to buy in the next 5 years. In addition, half of Gen Z lives and prefers the suburbs. As the Gen Z cohort matures over the coming decade, expect it to play an increasing role in the economy and housing. Enjoy the week, plan to take some time off this summer and recharge. We'll be back next week with another update.